You all are the glory of Zion, and I really want to thank God for each and every one of you. The blessedness of creation is who you are, and I thank God for your manifestation. There is an unusual glory that is about to hit the earth in this hour. Glory like never before. And this glory is for people who have been faithful to the things of the Father. And the glory that is here is about to accelerate some things in which a lot of people have been expecting. John chapter 17 and verse 1 declares, it says, after Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the hour has come. And I want a lot of you to understand today that your time and your moment and your hour has come, because the hour that has come is the hour of glory that is about to be seen in your life. Now is the time that the glory that has always been inside of you is about to be made manifest. This glory is bringing about reconciliation, is bringing about rejoicing, is bringing about transformation, transfiguration, and is about accelerating the things that I have spoken in your life in times past. For this glory, you're going to see it magnificently move upon creation, in cities, in nations, in towns, in businesses, with leaders, with government. You're going to see this glory, because the same way the Bible declares that at night the Spirit was moving in Egypt, this is where you're going to begin to see the Spirit of the Lord moving upon the earth according to Genesis and chapter 1 and verse 2. It says, and the Holy Ghost, do you see it? Holy Ghost was hovering over the face of the deep. And God said, let there be, and there was. Now, this is where you're going to begin to see the glory of the Lord manifest. That what has been spoken, let there be. You're going to begin to see it manifest in acceleration, because the glory of the Lord is here, and is here to reconcile, is here to transform, is here to bring about the change in which nations have been praying for. For the hour has come. It says, glorify your Son. Many of you, you have been doing things right behind the scene. You have been serving faithfully. You have been giving faithfully. You have been doing what the Lord has instructed you to do, and you have been doing it in an amazing and magnificent hour. And this is the time. This is the moment. This is the season, because Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, there is a time and a season. You have entered into the time of John 17 and 1, and the season of the glory of God, which you're about to see manifest. This is not what you have to do. The Bible declares in John chapter 6, it says to believe in the one he sent, and the believing is where you're going to see the glory made manifest. The Bible declares also in the book of Revelation, it says, God is the glory and Christ is the light, and God himself is here on earth to do in your life what has never been done before. What have you been waiting for? What have you been praying for? What have you been believing God for? What have you been trusting the Lord for? What have you been crying to him for? Weeping may endure for the night, but I want to remind you this very day that your joy has arrived, because the glory is here to manifest that in which you have been weeping in the night for. Do you remember in the days of Solomon? Yes, that Solomon, the one whom I gave wisdom to. What happened to him? It says when he sacrificed bulls, he sacrificed all of these things. It says, after the temple had been built, the glory of the Lord came into the temple. And what happened? He said they could not stand in the temple. Why couldn't they stand? Because the glory of the Lord was so strong, they couldn't even stand near it. Do you see another dimension of the glory that Moses had when he was in the wilderness coming down from the mountain? He had to cover with the veil. But we are the glory of the Lord. And because of the glory, we don't need any covering, because we are the manifestation and the ever exact image of the presence of God. And for that reason, that in which you have been waiting for, the glory of the Lord is about accelerating it. Now, I want you to understand that the glory of the Lord is in two dimensions. For a lot of you who have been waiting for a manifestation, the glory of the Lord is quickening it. And where there needs to be a refining, the glory of the Lord is bringing about that refining in order to bring the manifestation of the promise. So the two dimensions, you're going to see it even in the body as the glory begins to accelerate. Yes, because what has existed in the body for a long time, this is where there is a shaking happening because of the glory of the Father. For those who have continued to profane the things of God, they've turned the very center of the Father. They've turned our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, they've turned him into an entertainment center. And for that reason, because they have done that, there is a refining that is coming, a shutting down for there to be a lifting up. And the shutting down is not permanent, because in the book of Daniel chapter 4, he cut down the tree and he says, leave the stump in the ground. Why? Because for this refinement, when they change, you will see the glory begin to accelerate that tree to grow once again. And did you see what happened to Nebuchadnezzar when he acknowledged that the Lord is God? Yes, the tree was restored, and God even made him greater than he was before. That is the dimension of those who have been profaning the things of God, who have been making mockery of the things of God. And you're going to begin to see that So when everything is beginning to show as things are shutting down, please don't let your heart rejoice, but pray for them. Because in this refining, the Father, when it's all said and done, there is an elevation. So for you at the same time, who have been believing the Lord, you have gone through the refining, you have gone through the fire, and it was in the time of the Hebrew boys in Daniel chapter 3, they refused to bow. You refuse to bow to the circumstances around you. You refuse to bow to compromise. You refuse to bow when they told you to stop sharing the word. You refused to bow when they persecuted you for no reason. Now is the time that the glory of the Lord, do you see in John chapter 17, it says, glorify your son, that your son may glorify you. And do you see what the Father said in the book of John? It says, Father, glorify your name. It says, I have glorified it and I will glorify it again. Now your name's majority of you are being glorified. People are going to begin to love you and they don't know why they are loving you, because the glory of the Lord is upon your name. People are going to love your business. They don't know why they love it, because the glory of the Lord is resting upon it. People are going to love every dimension of your ministry. Why? Because the glory of the Lord has risen upon it. For your marriage, the glory of the Lord is bringing reconciliation over your children. When you've been praying for them, Father, I've been praying for this boy, I've been praying for this girl, but I see no change. And the Lord is helping you to understand, now is the hour you're going to begin to see those changes begin to manifest because of your faithfulness in prayer to me. You're going to see the dimension of the glory of God like never before. A lot of you, the glory of God is bringing about reconciliation even in the body. It is a place where you begin to understand the dimension of that glory being revealed. A lot of people, you're going to see the manifestation of the reversal. Yes, I said reversal, where a lot of people are going to begin to look younger once again because of the glory of the Father accelerating even the body. A lot of people are going to begin to look younger. Health are going to be restored. Yes, immortality being restored because the presence of God. You begin to see the joy of the Lord begin to overflow because of this glory. There is an overflow. Overflow manifesting even upon creation in sanctuary. For a lot of you, you have not laughed in a long time, because some of you, you have continued to endure. You have continued to persevere, and it feels like you're not even able to continue. Some of you, you're not even interested in doing what you were passionate about right before. But now is the hour. According to Genesis chapter 1, it says, and the Spirit of the Lord was hovering over. This is the Spirit. This is the glory. This is the manifestation of the presence of the sovereignty of God that is manifesting in creation. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has he entered into the hearts of man what the Lord is about to do in the glory that is being revealed upon creation. So it is not going to be business as usual. It is going to be a transformational period where you're going to begin to see those who were looked down upon, all of a sudden they were lifted up. Some of you, you're going to go to bed for whatever it is that you've been doing and you thought there was no fruit right in it. By the time you wake up in the morning, there is a dimension in the book of Mark that says the farmer went about sowing the seed and then he went to bed. How it was planted, but how it grew, he did not know. Why did he not know? Because it was the Lord that was giving it increase. Some of you, you're going to go to bed and it's like, wow, you know, I made all these products and I sold nothing. And you're going to wake up literally 24 hours later. Have you ever seen that before? Yes, it happened in 1 Kings chapter 7. It says, by this time tomorrow. Yes, because within 1 minute, there was famine in the land. And the next minute, there was abundance in the land. So you can see, you go to bed one night, you wake up in the morning, all of a sudden, your phone is going off. Sir, we want your product. Sir, we want your services. And you're wondering, who recommended me to you? Well, I want you to understand, nobody recommended them. It was the dimension of Luke chapter 2. Can you hear it? Can you see it? Yeah, because while the shepherds were in the wilderness, the Bible says the angel of the Lord came and he began to give them the good news. He said, behold, I bring you good tidings. And this is the good tidings that I'm bringing to you today, that the glory of the Lord is about to do this. Because you have to understand, in the book of Revelation chapter 21, he said, God is the glory. So you can begin to see, this is God himself manifesting in creation to bring about the abundance that you have been believing, you have been trusting and faithfully waiting on. Because now is the hour that I am elevating majority of you. For those that have been in the wilderness, this is you coming to the forefront. For those that have those of you that have been waiting in the palace, this is you coming to the forefront, because your hour has come. The time is set, because the glory of the Lord, as Jesus looked up to the heaven and he prayed, Father, the hour, Father, Father, the hour, your hour today, it has come and is glorifying you because you are the Son, that whatever He has placed in you may begin to glorify Him. Your finances, glorifying Him. Your journey, glorifying Him. Your marriage, glorifying Him. Your business, glorifying Him. Your family, glorifying Him. Every dimension of your life from this moment, begin to glorify God because He's glorifying you, that you may glorify Him. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. I love each and every one of you. You all are the faithfulness of the Father, and I honor and I love you all. Blessed are you. Yes, blessed are you. Blessed are you. Blessed are you, because you are the blessing. I love you all. Stay blessed, because you are the blessedness of the one who called you right from the very beginning. In Jesus' name, amen.